for more racial diversity within Pride festivals has been heard across Canada. And while this protest holding up Edmonton's parade last summer started a conversation, there's a group that's frustrated this week after they were locked out of a meeting and the police were called.
It escalated so quickly.
Victoria Guzman was with a group that tried to attend a meeting with the Edmonton Pride Festival Thursday relating to recent demands brought by members of the queer, trans, and people of color community, only to be locked out.
We were invited to present a speech at this meeting. We were not aware that it was closed off. We were not told that it could only be like two people or three people invited into the space.
But says when they realized the meeting space was largely empty, the group of around 30 made their way in. That's when the police were called.
So there was a lot of aggressive speech, and eventually the group did push their way into the building we were having the meeting in. Several members did feel unsafe.
Now, the current demands are different from those that halted last summer's parade and were adopted the same day, banning police and military from marching in uniform, and more space for trans and people of color in the festival, and a restructure of sorts. Additional issues brought forward have to do with the structure of some events and funding additional supports for groups like LGBTQ refugees.
The parade to be changed just to a protest march, for those groups to have oversight of who's approved to be in it. That currently is not our mandate.
For the last, like, how many decades where they have been implementing policies that don't center, you know, Black and Indigenous and racialized queer and trans people.
For Guzman, she believes there are systemic issues with the organization and was frustrated with the treatment by the board having the police called.
Some of them laughing at us, you know, during a moment where it was pretty heated, you know, when people were feeling unsafe.
Now, in speaking with the Pride Festival board, they did say they have yet to reach out to the groups that were locked out, but do say that in the weeks leading up to Edmonton's Pride, they will be having more conversations. From Edmonton, Carly Robinson, City News.